Now we just came back from our first 1.5 weeks of spending time at our new property that we bought in Sweden, and just being there made me realize how absolutely insanely massive this project that we bought actually is. And it also made me realize that I need to get my life back together, because otherwise things are not going to end well. Now, one of the things that I really need to do is I need to get back into exercise, because I haven't been able to do any exercise ever since the first time I had COVID. And I actually had COVID 4 times in the last 2 years, and it did a really bad number on me. So I haven't been the same since. And then another thing that I also really need to do is I need to de-stress a little bit. And I just need to take some time to process all of the things that happened in the last couple of months. And I really think that organizing my stuff and moving all of my things to my new home is going to help a lot, because my life has been packed into boxes for almost a year now. And I also want to spend a little bit more time on the way I look, actually, because I am done with just looking like a basket case too. Oh, and the barn project. I'm getting back into the barn project. Now that's very exciting too. This outfit, you guys, is nice and all. It's also very unpractical and very unflattering when I'm pulling my shirt down. Now, moving everything to Sweden is actually something that we are going to tackle in stages, because we are going to make a couple of trips and we are just going to take a big load of stuff every time we go. And right now I'm actually preparing for the next trip, and this means that I'm going to sort out all of my personal things, because these are the things that I want to take. And by the way, I am repacking everything, because the boxes that I used the first time are falling apart. So my plan is to mainly use these bins, except for a couple of really big things, because they don't fit into the bins. And then I'm going to unpack all of the things over there and bring the bins back over here. So in that way, they are going to be reusable. Now, I actually already started packing yesterday, but then emotions took over a little bit. It is a little mouse that I bought for my granddaughter, and she's beautiful, by the way. She has orange hair. She looks like me. And I was planning to make all of these little things, you know, little blankets and little pillows. This is what it came with, by the way. But I was planning to make an entire set of all kinds of things, and I was also planning to make all kinds of little outfits, because it only came with one pair of pants. But I never did any of these things, because it's going to be pointless, you know, because by the time that she might be old enough to get this, she's going to be an adult. When I was sorting out all kinds of little areas of the house in Sweden, I found a lot of vintage buttons. And I told you guys that I was planning to start a vintage button collection. The funny thing is, though, that I actually already did that even before we bought this house. Because I bought this little box on the flea market. And this is just a little box full of buttons that came from a shop that somebody decided to use for a collection of all kinds of buttons in brown. My books, I lost my books. Oh, there's one, and this is a really big one actually, that has little locks. I don't really know what it is about. Now, I think that it is about religion. But this is a little bit of a guess. So if there are any Swedish people watching this video, maybe you can tell me what this book is all about. And I will show you the other books too, because those books are also very interesting. As soon as I have managed to locate the location. yeah, let's move on to some vintage and colorful art. And these are actually things that I need to hang. So this is another little project. Because these two things, even though they aren't things that I would normally buy, are things that I think are great for the gallery wall that I started in the hallway up here. It's one very cheerful little girl from probably Switzerland, I think, and two adorable little kittens. So I'm going to put this aside and then we will hang it somewhere later this week. Because I am going to pack all of the things sorted into categories, I think I need to start a box called Artisticness. Oh, there are so many vintage treasures. And the things that are going to be packed into these boxes are going to be things that are very useful to me on moments of when I am doing creative projects. There are also going to be other things that are just beautiful, but those things are related to some sort of a creative craft. So these are things that relate to something creative. And then there are also things that are beautiful in a certain way, and because of the beauty that they have, they trigger my creative energy. And there are so many of these things that we are just going to need to find a place for. And I actually collect all kinds of medical supplies. So the entire content of the little vintage emergency box that I showed you in Sweden is just an addition to something that I already collect too, just like the buttons. Ja, goed zo. Wat ben je dapper. could really use a little bit of cow TLC right now. I am actually having a really, really rough week. I'm not making any progress. Eva, just turn your brain off and just get rid of the mess. Because this is just not okay anymore. You really need to pull yourself together. I haven't done a single thing, except for exercise. That's something that I did every single morning, and that's also why I feel so tired. And how about you? How was your fitness level?
No, that's not eatable. That's not eatable. And what are you doing? What are you planning to do with my skirt? Huh? Hey, you are so cute. Yes, you are. You are so cute. Hey, sweetie pie. Did you miss me? Did you miss me?
Now, when it comes to moving stuff, we have decided that bigger is definitely going to be better. And I'm not really talking about this box, although this is going to be very helpful too. I'm actually talking about a giant trailer that we bought. So we are picking up this trailer today at the garage because there were a couple of things that needed to be fixed and now it is done. So this is exciting and huge because it is a lot bigger than what I was expecting. I think that we could actually just live in here.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is going to be amazing and it even has a carpet. We also picked up 5 little kitchens, all designed in the 30s by a designer called Piet Zwart. So all of these cabinets have the same size and the same style, and we are going to turn these 5 kitchens into one big kitchen. There are so many cabinets. So now just try to imagine yourself a very long wall with all of these beautiful old windows looking out on a field. And then underneath these windows we have this very long row of vintage kitchen cabinets, all painted beautifully in this creamy color of white. And then on top, a very rustic looking countertop made out of concrete and a very big double white apron sink. So now we have bought the vision, but we obviously still need to do the work. Okay, so this is one of those drawers and it's broken, so it needs to be fixed. But when it is fixed, you can just slide this out and then you can adjust it to the size of the drawer that it is in. And this is just really cool and very nifty. And it is going to be a lot of work to fix it. So now we are going to empty out this side of the attic, because this is the side of the barn where we are going to start with fixing the roof, because this is where we have the most leaks. And that's also why all of these kitchen cabinets are over there right now, because it's the only area of the barn that is kind of dry, except for the floor. And that's why all of these things are on top of my beautiful new marketplace boot. And this boot is gigantic. So it needs to be made a little bit smaller, actually. And more narrow. And then the boards that are left over are going to be used for something else. Now this part of the attic over here is already empty. And this is what we are going to empty out today. Okay, spiders, right now you have 5 minutes to move your little butts, tiny little spider butts, somewhere else, because your days of living up here are over. Yay! I'm so excited about finally getting back into this project. Thank you.
Dit is een bit nasty.
Wow. Tell me something that I don't know yet. It is like the little Dutch song about een tuintje in je hart. Huh?
Een tuintje in je hart?
Een klein tuintje in je hart? Hoe ging dat ook alweer? Ik heb een tuintje in mijn hart. Of niet? Ja, ja toch?
Ja. Ik heb een tuintje in mijn hart. Oké.
It means I have a little garden in my heart. This is not just about getting my life back together, but also about getting the barn back together. Drop it. So that was the wisdom part of this video. And what more do you want for a YouTube video? Well, some progress would be nice. Are you an empty box hoarder?
Yes.
Is there anything else that I need to know now that we are married?
Wat een schattig doosje.
Oh, it's a baby box. It's exactly what we need.
Ja.
Totally unnecessary stuff. Power for professionals. Okay, so this is how it looks right now. And our goal is to start taking down these boards. These moldy, horrible boards. So now that we made the barn look like a murder room from Dexter, we can finally have some fun.
Oh, I don't like this at all. Oh my god, Rogier, I'm having a panic attack. Oh no, 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 no. Oh, breathing, breathing out. Oh, there are so many. I don't like this.
next week I'm going to dive back into the country and western style farmhouse bedroom makeover. I'm also going to add the two little paintings and a couple of other very colorful things to the gallery wall in the hallway. I am obviously going to keep you updated on the progress in the barn and on my quest for a more balanced and healthier lifestyle. And then I'm also going to show you all of the things that we bought in an amazing shop that I showed you in this video. And we are going to celebrate that autumn is finally here.